we'll be talking about the climatic classification of India. We have talked about the physiography, drainage, vegetation and soils in India. Now, the next important topic is the climatic classification of India. It's important to note that in this lecture, we are focusing on the climatic classification with a special reference to India. We'll be discussing the general climate classification in a separate lesson where we'll be talking about the Köppen and Thornwright's classification. Here, we'll be talking about three major classifications. The first was given by Köppen. The next was given by Stamp and Andrew. And finally, we have the R.L. Singh's classification. Now, the Köppen's classification, that is the first classification we'll be discussing, is based on three major parameters. The first parameter we have as the mean monthly temperature. The second parameter would be the mean monthly rainfall. And the third parameter would be mean annual rainfall. So we have monthly as well as annual for rainfall, and then we have the mean monthly temperature. Based on these three parameters, Köppen broadly classified the climate of India in three divisions. The first is the humid, that's A, known as or classified as A, the major classification. Then you have the subhumid, that's classified as B, and finally you have the semi-arid, that's C and D. So those are the broad classification that Köppen did. Based on that, he divided Indian, the country of India into various regions. We'll be discussing these one by one. So the first region is AW, that's the tropical monsoon region. Now this tropical monsoon region covers most of the states. You have Maharashtra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, parts of Andhra Pradesh, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh. So these are the major regions, and southern Gujarat are the major regions that are covered under tropical savanna. Now this tropical savanna region, the temperature here varies from 27 degrees to 40 degrees. You have rainfall usually by southwest monsoons with winters as dry. Most of the areas, as we say, in the peninsular area are covered under the tropical savanna region. Then within the A, that's the humid classification, we have two more, that's AMW and AS. AMW is the tropical monsoon. The tropical monsoon region is mainly found in the coastal areas of Karnataka, and you have most of the Kerala within the tropical monsoon region. The rainfall here is heavy during the southwest monsoon season, or the monsoon season you have very heavy rainfall with dry winters in this region. The climate here is mostly humid. The next classification is AS, that is tropical moist, found in most of the parts of Tamil Nadu, and then you have few parts of Andhra Pradesh and partially Telangana that you have here, which is covered under AS, that is the tropical moist region. The summers are dry. The average temperature here is 18 degrees Celsius. Rainfall is usually between 100 to 150 centimeters in this region. And most of the rainfall, nearly 75% of the rainfall, is caused by the retreating monsoon. That's in the month of October to December. You have the winter rainfall here. Then, so this was the A classification. Then we move on to the B classification. The B classification is the arid classification. You have the arid and the semi-arid as C and D. So you have A as humid, B as arid. Sorry for the mistake here previously. So B is for arid and C and D for semi-arid. Now B that's arid is classified into two, that's BW, HW and BS, HW. So BS, HW is the semi-arid steppes. While you have BWHW as the arid climate. So west of Aravallis, so this if I say corresponds to the Aravalli belt, and the west of Aravalli would be BWHW with very cold winters and very cold nights, and you have rainfall less than 25 centimeters in this region. While you have a belt of BSHW, that's the eastern Gujarat, you have eastern Rajasthan, the Kutch region and the parts of Punjab and Haryana towards the west is covered under semi-arid steppes. The rainfall here is usually in the summer. It's usually follows the rain shadow parts you have for the eastern Karnataka and western Tamil Nadu, western Telangana as well. So you have the semi-arid climate in these two regions. The temperature here is usually 18 degrees Celsius. And rainfall from around 25 to 50 degrees Celsius. Then you have CWG, that's the Ganga Plains, the region of Ganga Plains, I could say the Ganga Brahmaputra Plains, and it's mainly the mesothermal climate that's seen here with less of distinct variations that you can see. Rainfall is usually common in the summer months, with the highest temperature peaking in around the month of May and June. You have the mesothermal climate in the Ganga Plains, and then you have the climatic classification, that's ET, that's the tundra climate, and E is the polar climate usually found in the regions of Himachal Pradesh, Uttarakhand, you have Jammu Kashmir, parts of Leh and Ladakh. The temperature soars down to minus and you have 0 degrees Celsius as the freezing temperature here, with most of the regions or the peaks of the mountains having this climate, usually commonly found in the altitudinal region with high altitudes. You have the ET or the tundra type climate, and finally you have the DFC, that's the cold humid winter in this region. You will find usually found in the northern parts of the states of Arunachal Pradesh and Assam, North Assam, you have this kind of climate. The temperature is usually 10 to 18 degrees Celsius with cold humid winters. So this was the basic classification given by Köppen. I repeat, so the broad classification is A, that is humid, B, that is arid, not subhumid. I repeat again, so A is for humid, B is for arid, and C and D for semi-arid classification, and its classification was based on the three main elements, that's the mean monthly temperature, mean monthly rainfall and mean annual rainfall. So that was the basic classification. The next classification is given by Stamp and Kandrew. He classified the country into 11 subdivisions and two broad divisions. The two broad divisions were the tropical region and the subtropical region. Now his classification was very simple. He classified the country into two parts based on the isotherm, and he demarcated 18 degree isotherm as the line of distinguishing the subtropical and the tropical region. Isotherm is the line that joins points of equal temperature. So this is the line here that joins the line of equal temperature or 18 degree isotherm. The northern portion is the subtropical, and the southern portion below this 18 degree isotherm is the tropical region. So as you can see, the first five are classified under subtropical region and the last six are classified into tropical region. So you have the classification for the subtropical and the tropical. We will start with the subtropical first. So this region, the region marked as 1, is the Himalayan region, following the north of the northeast states. Then you have Jammu Kashmir, northern parts of Himachal Pradesh and northern parts of Uttarakhand, Leh Ladakh, Lahul Spiti, which fall under the first region, that's the Himalayan region. This region has mild summer and cold winters. The temperature is usually from 4 to 8 degrees in summers and in winters. Sorry, winters it's 4 to 8 degrees and in summers it's around 10 to 12 degrees Celsius. That's the optimum temperature in this region. The vegetation is mainly coniferous and pine. Then the next region is the northwest region, found in the northwest of the Satluj region. The rainfall in the summer is due to southwest monsoon and in the winter is due to the western disturbances caused in this region. So you have winter rainfall due to western disturbances and summer rainfall due to southwest monsoon. So you have both summer and winter rainfall in this region. That's the region 2, or I could say the northwest region that we are discussing here. That's found here. The next is third, that's the arid lowland, mainly the desert region of Rajasthan. Then you have the Kutch areas, the western Gujarat, parts of western Madhya Pradesh that fall under the arid lowland region. The annual rainfall is very less in this region. You have rainfall between or less than 25 centimeters and temperature from 15 to 40 degrees Celsius. The summer temperature is around 40 degrees Celsius or higher, while the winter temperature drops below 15 degrees Celsius in nights. Then you have the region of moderate rainfall. That's the main region of the Ganga Plain, I could say. You have rainfall of moderate amount that you can see here. So 40 to 100 centimeters is the rainfall. As you see here, towards the north, as we move from west to east, the amount of rainfall increases. So this region has the highest rainfall, with Cherrapunji and Maelstrom in this region. You have the region of moderate rainfall with 100 centimeters of rainfall here. And the temperature in the months of January is 15 to 18 degrees Celsius, while in the month of summers, that's around June and July, the temperature spikes up to 30 to 35 degrees Celsius in the region of moderate rainfall. Then you have the transitional zone that acts as a transition between the region of moderate rainfall and very heavy rainfall. This region has a rainfall from around 100 to 150 centimeters. So as you can see, the Stamp and Kendrew's classification from west to east is mainly focusing on the amount of rainfall, and he clearly explains that the amount of rainfall increases as we move towards the east. So you have the eastern part of Madhya Pradesh, eastern part of Uttar Pradesh, then you have northern Bihar, you have parts of Jharkhand that are included under the region of transition zone. So these are the major subtropical regions that we have discussed. Now we move on to the tropical region. So according to the tropical region, you have tropical region 6, that's the region of very heavy rainfall that I explained. The rainfall increases towards the east, and you have the higher rainfall regions of Cherrapunji and Maelstrom in the bordering areas of Assam here. So the rainfall here is around 200 centimeters. That's very high rainfall, mainly caused by southwest monsoon. Then you have region 7, that's the region of heavy rainfall, from around 150 to 200 centimeters of rainfall. Parts of Odisha, Jharkhand, you have northern Andhra Pradesh in this region. Then you have 8, that's the region of moderate rainfall again. So if I combine 4 and 8, I get a region of moderate rainfall. So I have a region of moderate rainfall here and here. So I can say this whole belt is a region of moderate rainfall with around 40 to 100 centimeters of rainfall. The only difference here being that one lies in the subtropical region, which has a lower temperature, while other lies in a tropical region which has a comparatively higher temperature. The temperature here spikes up to 32 degrees Celsius in the months of July and August, and not below 18 degrees Celsius usually in the summer months. Then you have the Konkan coast, that's the 9, this region. You have the Konkan coast or the western parts of Maharashtra and Karnataka region. The temperature usually varies from 24 to 27 degrees. So in the months of summer, it's around 24 degrees Celsius in the months of winter, it's around 24 degrees Celsius, and in summer, it's around 27 degrees Celsius. So as you can see, the variation of temperature here is not very huge or not very large. The next is the Malabar coast towards the southern region covers most of the parts of Kerala. The annual rainfall or the annual temperature I could say here is around 27 degrees Celsius. Again, the variations in the temperature are very less towards the Malabar coast. The famous point here is Kochi, based on which we classify this region as the Malabar coast. Usually it runs from Goa till Cape Coromandel. You have this whole belt which has a kind of temperature which has very less variations. And finally you have the Tamil Nadu coast towards the east, which includes the most of the part of Tamil Nadu and eastern parts of Andhra Pradesh. The temperature variation here is around 24 degrees in winters to around 30 degrees Celsius to 32 degrees Celsius in summers. So that's the temperature variation. Most of the rainfall in the Tamil Nadu coast is caused by the retreating monsoon. That's in the month from October to December, and that's the winter rainfall. The final classification that we'll be studying today was given by R.L. Singh. He is a well-known geographer from India, and in 1971, he classified India into various regions. His classification was based on both qualitative and quantitative terms. Now, we'll start with the classification from the eastern side towards the western side. So, we'll start with the regions as humid northeast. So, rainfall here is more than 200 centimeters. So, region of very heavy rainfall, more than 200 centimeters of rainfall. So, in this classification, we'll be focusing mainly on the rainfall and the summer and the winter temperatures. So, summer temperature would be around 25 to 30 degrees Celsius or 33 degrees Celsius, and winter temperature around 10 to 25 degrees Celsius. As you can see, it covers most of the northeastern states. The next is the subhumid transitional region with a rainfall of around 100 to 200 centimeters, covering region of Bihar, north of Jharkhand and eastern Uttar Pradesh. The temperature variation is again for winters 10 to 25 degrees Celsius, but for summers it has a higher temperature range of 25 to around 44 degrees Celsius that it can spike up. The next is the subhumid continental region or the subhumid continental climate. It covers the central part of the Ganga Plains. The temperature, the rainfall usually here is 75 to 150 centimeters in this region, covering most of the region where Ganga meets the tributaries of Yamuna, Gandak and Kosi. You have winter temperature from around 17 to 25 degrees Celsius, while summer temperature spikes up to 40 degrees Celsius in this region. Then you have the semi-arid subtropical region with rainfall from around 25 to 75 degrees Celsius, centimeters, sorry. As we move west, the rainfall is decreasing, similar to the pattern what Stamp and Kendry suggested. So, this region has a rainfall of around 25 to 75 degrees Celsius, and the temperature you have moderate intensity 25 to 28 degrees Celsius in summers, while in winters it has a much lower temperature as compared to here, from around 25 to 22 degrees Celsius I could say. Then you have the arid region with rainfall less than 25 centimeters in this region. However, the temperature variations are very high in this region. Being a desert region, the nights become very cold and the days become very hot, and similarly is the scenario with summers and winters. So, summers spike up to 40 degrees Celsius and winters you have 0 to 10 degrees Celsius as the minimum temperature in this region. Then you have the western Himalayan climate towards the north. It's usually around 150 centimeters of rain that you can see. Again, there is a climatic, the rainfall gradient that follows towards the east. You have eastern side with higher rainfall, western sides with lesser amount of rainfall. The temperature variations in the summer are usually 5 to 30 degrees Celsius, while in winters it's 0 to 5 degrees Celsius. Now, as you can see, towards the western parts and the northern parts, you have huge temperature variations that exist, but that is not the phenomena towards the south. Now, let's move on to the southern region. You have humid southeast region that has a rainfall of around 100 to 200 centimeters. Now, this region has a relatively higher rainfall covering most of the parts of Odisha, Jharkhand, you have northern Andhra Pradesh and Chhattisgarh region under humid southeast region. The temperature variations also is not very large. You have 12 to 27 degrees during winters, while 25 to 32 degrees during summers. The next is semi-arid tropical. So similar to what Stamp and Kendrew suggested, he classified this region again as semi-arid, but this was semi-arid subtropical and this is semi-arid tropical, just the difference being the temperature. The rainfall here he suggested was around 50 to 100 centimeters, a bit higher as compared to the semi-arid subtropical region. And finally, he suggested that this region, the temperature varies from 26 to 40 degrees Celsius during the months of summer, while in the months of winter, you have temperature from 15 to 25 degrees Celsius. Now, the next region is the humid Sihadris and the western coast running from the coast of Goa till Cape Coromandel. He combined this region as one and he said this region is a region of heavy rainfall, especially in the month of southwest monsoons or the arrival of monsoon season. You have rainfall around 200 centimeters. The temperature variations are very less, 25 to 30 degrees Celsius during the months of summer, while in the months of winter, it's around 20 to 25 degrees Celsius. So the range of temperature, the annual range of temperature in the case of humid Sahadris and western coast is very less. Finally, you have the subhumid littorals which are known for the winter rainfall, or I could say this is analogous to the region propounded by Stamp and Kendrew, which was the Tamil Nadu coastal regions known for winter rainfall caused by retreating monsoon. The rainfall here is around 75 to 100 centimeters, and again the variation on the temperature is not very huge. During the summer months during the winter it's around 20 to 25 degrees Celsius, while in the summers it's 28 to 35 degrees Celsius. So again the variation of the temperature, the annual variations in the temperature is not very huge. So these were the three famous climatic classification we need to know with respect to India. We will be covering the climatic classification given by Köppen and Thornwald in the further sessions that we will be talking about in the section on climatology. You can subscribe to our channel, that's Exam Race on YouTube, and you will get updates on more videos related to geography and for the concepts related to the geography of India and physical geography as well. Have a good day ahead.